Phương Dung xin kính chào quý vị khán giả VNTV. Hôm nay Phương Dung rất hân hạnh được chào đón tiến sĩ Kevin LaChapelle một lần nữa đến với chương trình VNTV của chúng ta. Trong những chương trình vừa qua, tiến sĩ Kevin LaChapelle đã chia sẻ khó khăn mà ông phải vượt qua trên đường đời để đưa đến sự thành công của ông ngày hôm nay. Vì sự thành công đó, ông đã tạo ra một trung tâm tên là Power Mentor. Trung tâm này là trung tâm để tư vấn và giúp đỡ những người trải qua những sự khó khăn trong cuộc sống, nhất là trong đường học vấn. Để nói thêm những chi tiết về trung tâm Power Mentor, Phương Dung hôm nay rất hân hạnh được mời tiến sĩ Kevin LaChapelle đến với VNTV một lần nữa. Hello Kevin.
How are you?
Hello Johnny. Hello. How are you doing today?
Doing well. Very good.
I believe that you came to VNTV a couple of times already.
Yes.
And you have shared about your difficulty of get to where your success today.
Mm-hmm.
And with all of that, you have given back to the community by really establish a very powerful power mentor organization mm-hmm. for our community. I would love for you to just go into a very short a description again about Power Mentor and what is it that people need to know about Power Mentor.
Sure. Well, Power Mentor, primarily we're engaging people generally that maybe feel like they maybe can't do something or they can't move forward in their life, maybe vulnerable populations. And this came from me when I was young. And so I try to basically do for others what I kind of wished I would have had. Somebody that can tell me that I can do things instead of telling me what I can't do. And then maybe kind of walking alongside me and showing me and teaching me as we go along. And that's kind of what Power Mentor is.
So basically with Power Mentor, you try to bring out a positive characteristic of a person instead of the negative.
That's right.
And you solution-driven instead
That's right.
of problem-driven.
Absolutely.
And I also noticed that for Power Mentor, you pretty much wanted the individual to be passionate about becoming a successful person so that he not just helping himself, but helping others
That's
to
right.
go through the same issue
Absolutely.
To become successful.
Mm-hmm.
And Johnny, how do you come about to join Power Mentor with Dr. Kevin?
Well, for me, right out of high school, I didn't necessarily have a direction. So I didn't know what I wanted to be. Coming from, you know, a Vietnamese American family, there's a lot of pressure to become a doctor or a lawyer.
Mm-hmm.
But those weren't things that I wanted to become. So, you know,
I know that's the only two things that we know, doctor or dentist or engineer, actually three,
engineer,
right?
Yeah.
And then as soon as I came to United States, I'm like, oh my God, there's so many other degrees that I can get beside that three. But because we so like brainwashed
right.
to only become that three.
That's right.
But for me, I believe if you best at what you do, doesn't matter what career you are in,
yes.
you
exactly.
will, the money will just come right after.
Absolutely.
But you have to be passionate about it first.
That's right.
Yes.
Right. So, you know, I felt, through some friends, I got introduced to a job, and in that job, that's where I met Kevin. And so from then on, you know, he has been an influence in my life to kind of find a purpose for myself. And since then, I've completed college, received my master's in health administration, and working on my doctorate in education. So.
Oh, great.
Yes.
Good for you, Dr. Kevin. You have done great things.
Well, I learned more from them than they probably learned from me. So.
I think we all learn from each
That's
other,
right.
no matter what age we are, at
That's
what
right.
level, you know, learning never stops.
Mm-hmm.
Knowledge
mm-hmm.
is power. And let me ask you, I know that if they want more information, they can always go on powermentor.org
That's
or
right.
they can go on 1-888-MENTOR-2.
844-MENTOR-2.
So, 844-MENTOR-2 to get yes. more information. Mm-hmm. Now, I'm very excited to hear about the trip coming up in December, and
yes.
I would really love for you to go in detail about that trip
sure.
and how they can get qualified either to help for that trip or to join in to go with you as
sure.
well.
Well, this has been probably the most powerful project that we've ever engaged, and this will be the fourth year that we actually take a group down there. And this happened some years ago when I met members, refugees from the Karen,
mm-hmm.
It was called Karen State in between Thailand and Burma. And they were having challenges because they were being picked on a lot and bullied. And so that's how I got involved. And I asked them, what did they want to do? And they said, one day we want to go back to our country and help our people. And so that really hit me that that was something else that I was like, wow, they actually want to be able to do that. And they were very passionate about it. And many of them wanted to become nurses, pilots, attorney, politician, and they were journeying through college. And so it took several years, took a few years of planning, and then we took our first trip, and it was absolutely amazing. And I think the greatest thing was, as many people see refugee populations as victims, we see them as victors. And so to be able to take people and let them go back to their country and actually help people was so empowering for them. It was the most unbelievable experience. And we do three basic things: medical outreach, community building, and leadership development. So those are the three different main project themes that we have when we go there. And so then participants kind of pick whichever they want to gravitate towards. Obviously, nurses and things are going to pick medical outreach. Community building could be a lot of things. It could be environmental. It can be for planting to grow food. It can be just a number of things, water source. And then you look at leadership development, covers all sorts of other things, from entrepreneurship, how do you start a business, to how do you lead people and how do you engage people. So it's been just amazing. And we have a lot of videos on our website that people can see. And this year we have over 60 participants, and from all over. We have people from Norway, Netherlands, Australia, Canada, and of course a lot from the United States. And so it's just going to be amazing, and each year it just seems to get better.
So let me ask you, give two options. Option number one, if they want to go with you on the trip, what is the requirement for age limit, and what is the deadline for them to file out the application to go, and what is the two requirements that you mentioned, the tickets and the money that they have to pay for food and transportation. So if you can go into that order for me.
So the first is they definitely have to be 18 or older. It's for adults. And they should be in decent condition, as far as there's a lot of walking and things. For the flight, you know, they can probably go up until, I would say, November is going to start getting challenging for the flights. They have to pay for their flight, which depends. For many that started early in January, the flights were $700 and $600. Mm-hmm. Now they're probably around $800 or $900. And we kind of help them coordinate that. And then the only fee for when we're over there is $400 that helps cover the ground transportation. We have to rent a lot of vans and things, and that's costly. And other than that, we actually don't stay in hotels. We stay in villages with all the people that we're working with. So whoever wants to go, they definitely have to be able to really like the outdoors and know that they're going to be in the outdoors a lot. And they have to obviously love people, and they have to really enjoy working in team environments, because this is very team driven. And we use a strategy called project-based learning. So many times these are, a lot of them are college students, because I teach at the university. So these college students, I kind of know what program they're in. And then we'll continue it on for some time, internships, for example, into the area of specialty that they're learning about. So now when they get there, they get to apply all the things they've been learning. And this just really accelerates that leadership development by using projects to where they see things come alive right out there in the field, especially for public health issues and things too.
Great. So if option number two, if they cannot join you for the trip, what can they do to really be able to help Power Mentor to continue on having these meaningful trip for different country?
So, you know, something happened 2 weeks ago where a guy on Facebook said, I really want to go, but I don't have any money. And surprisingly, someone joined the conversation and said, if you really want to go, I will pay for your ticket. And someone paid for this student's ticket. So, I mean, it was amazing. So we have sometimes that. We also have people that will donate either medical supplies. People try to donate clothes, but we cannot take, because we have to take everything over there on the airplane. So medical things is really good, like pulse oximeters, blood pressure cuffs, stethoscopes, things like that. And some people donate funds so that when we get to Thailand, we can go buy medication so that we can take that to the villages. And we actually partner with a lot of organizations that are already over there. We kind of come there and then kind of help replenish anything that they need, because they've been working with so many people. And we not only go to the camps, like one camp has over 60,000 people there, but we also go into villages that really don't have any resources at all. So the other thing is, sometimes there is people that they need to kind of be emotionally strong. But with this trip, we actually have three social workers that are Karen that are coming with us. So that's going to be amazing. And we have debriefs every night for learning. What do we learn from today? All those kind of things.
So all the information they can definitely get on your website, powermentor.org, or the phone number once again, 1-844-MENTOR-2.
Yes.
Now, Johnny, I heard that you're going to go on the trip with Kevin as well.
Correct. I'll be on this trip this year.
What is your goal? Let's say that you join this trip. What is your goal to really get out from this trip?
My main goal is to, you know, be as helpful as I can. You know, even though, you know, I'm not Karen, I have a special heart for them. You know, because I've known them for the past few years, and just kind of learn more about, you know, their struggle, and, you know, be as helpful as I can, being kind of like a bridge to kind of help organize and kind of lead some of the initiatives over there. That way they can take that and build their own communities once, you know, we leave from out of, you know, the current state.
I think that's a really good point that mm-hmm. we don't create dependency on us. We're really mm-hmm. into empowering. And so we have a number of people from current state that live there that will meet us in when we get to different locations. And our goal there is to empower and develop them with leadership skills, and for them we also have projects so that it's kind of win-win. And also, if I'm mentoring Johnny, Johnny's going to be mentoring others. Everything is multi-level mentoring, so that even accelerates the learning even more, because then you learn what it's like to actually lead someone and the responsibility involved.
And project-based is something that much better, that's more right. interactive, that prepare them to the real mm-hmm. world. So can you kind of go into a little bit sure. more about project-based?
Well, it's funny because in the classroom, when I'm teaching graduate students, there's times that they say, well, tell us exactly in the assignment, do this, 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 and this, and how do we do it? Whereas, you know, we're really into saying, here's the problem, mm-hmm. you come up with the solution, and let's see how we get there, and let's do it through simulations first mm-hmm. so that there's very little risk. And then we have a plan in place, and then when they go there, they're going to apply this project-based learning. And so memorization is the lowest form of thinking. Critical thinking through project-based learning is where it's at, so people can be in a situation. And we will put them in situations that are very uncomfortable over there purposefully, allowing them to not have an easy answer. You have to come up with the answer. We're not going to tell you. And what we've found later when we've done interviews, we do an exit video for people kind of sharing what they learned. And they say they've never experienced anything like that, and it's been the most life-changing, and they cannot believe just the things that they learned that they never would have ever figured would have been a part of this trip. So it's really fascinating to see.
I think that's give them the tool and the skill of maneuver any situation that happened at
right.
that minute, at that time, and how to be able to have the solution for it instead of,
yes.
you know, to follow a theory. And then once it's yes. an application, they don't know what to do with it.
And they know this is a very challenging part of the world mm-hmm. right
Definitely.
Now. Definitely. You know, you've got the Rohingya issue going on,
yes.
all the other ethnic nationalities.
Politics, yes. why, yes, everything.
So they have to learn how mm-hmm. to, you know, we meet with high-level leaders over there mm-hmm. that they never thought they would meet. And they're going to have to learn how do you talk to them and get your point across and have that personal relationship rather than being able to just text to them. And it's interesting because we use social media as a huge spread and reach. So there are many, many people we only meet through social media until we see them face-to-face. And you can see the difference, how confident they were in the text messaging. And when you see them face-to-face, a little apprehension. And then by the end of these projects, those projects are also designed to help them come alive and to be the same person that they felt comfortable with in the online environment, to be like that in real life when they're face-to-face with people.
And I think that's also the positive of social media.
Yes.
I think that if you're looking at the positive key of social media, that you'll be able to reach to so many different people in
yes.
around the world, and yet you'll be able to combine that social media approach with the in-person approach so that they can have both, that they be able to survive through the real
yes.
world out there, because
Absolutely.
You definitely need to have both. You
oh,
need to have
so
the social
much.
Media skill, but you also have to have the communication
right.
skill in person for you to be able to have the enough vocabulary or language to
yeah.
communicate with different kind of
and
people.
To connect with people. In unique
people.
Ways
yes.
and memorable ways.
And
you
then
know?
Communication is a key to
Absolutely.
Anything, to relationship,
yes.
to study, to anything
yeah.
up that you do in the world. So Johnny, let me ask you, since you joined Power Mentor, what have you learned from Power Mentor that you would want to share with the audience of VNTV or anybody out there that's struggling right now, or they have an issue to really want to come to Power Mentor for help? What is it that you want to share with them so that give them the courage to make the first step to reach out to Power Mentor?
Well, the first thing I would say is to just to find that courage, and to be able to do that is to really look within and reflect about what is it in your life that moves you. So in other words, you know, what's your purpose? So that would be my advice. Just finding out, you know, what drives you, what motivates you. Take that and then move forward with that. And that will kind of give you the courage to pursue, whether it's through Power Mentor or other things that, you know, you find meaning in your life.
I think, and we've really done a lot of how do you align with the right people in your life to help you move forward, as opposed to being aligned with the wrong people that are holding you back?
Yes, I have the previous show we're talking about positive environment and positive energy and positive people.
Yes.
That will be able to, number one, generate that positive energy within you, and that give you the belief, and you manifest whatever positive thinking it will come to you. So as a result, let me kind of end the show with talking about the combination of social media and also the in-person connection. Can you give any of our audience or the young generation now the advice to how they combine the social media and the communication in person for us?
Well, I think, you know, social media again is good for superficial getting your reach out there. But how do you develop strong friendships that help you be able to be resilient and get through the tough times? Because there are tough times as we journey through our life. And I know for us, we have an annual breakfast and everyone have to speak at the breakfast, and that kind of breaks barriers. Some people are very nervous about that. But I would say encouraging young people to push past things that make them uncomfortable, knowing that there's light at the end of the tunnel. And as they master skills, things are gonna get better and better for them. And they never can let go of what Johnny said, that what is their dream when they were younger? What do they always dream? I wanna do this. And now how do they get the right people around them and push forward and actually meet that? And I think that's powerful. And then the other thing I would say is for young people to be careful when their parents are trying to guide them. Sometimes they see that as, well, leave me alone or leave me alone. They have to understand that that guidance is very critical for them. But that's only going to get them so far. Now who are they going to align themselves with when they're not around mom and dad? And that's very important.
I agree. As a college student and graduate student in the United States, it's not about avoiding you from hanging out with bad people.
Yeah.
It's to teach you how to not influence by what they do.
That's right.
And that's the key to our show today. And to just summarize, if you have struggling right now in your life and you want a guidance that will help you on financial or education, please reach out to powermentor.org or the phone number 1-844-MENTOR2. It will give you all the information you need so that you can connect to the right person, the right people to help you to become successful and to really make your dream come true. Because if you can dream, it will come true.
That's
just
right.
How hard you can work for it. And thank
Absolutely.
You so much, Dr. Kevin LaChapelle. Thank you, Johnny Vaugh, for coming here today.
Thank
and
you.
I'm very excited for the trip. And I could hope that everybody will watch the show today will either join in to help to provide for the trip or to join us to go with the trip. And I myself will try to see if I can manage to go as well. Thank you again and have a great, a wonderful day.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.